Hare Krishna. Opening the mouth without opening the mind helps neither the mouth nor the mind. We are all too often to give our opinions and to pass judgments about others without really understanding where they are coming from. How often do we speak words which hurt others and then we regret those words? And sometimes we may hurt others and we may not even regret it because we just are so convinced that we are right that even when we have spoken something very painful and something which may not even be true, not based on an incorrect understanding of reality, still we may just go along with our life causing enormous wounds to people's hearts by our inconsiderate words. The Bhagavad Gita urges us to practice discipline of speech by speaking words that are sensitive, that do not agitate other people. Anudvegakaram vakyam satyam priyahitam chayat svadhyayabhyasanam chaiva vanmayam tapa uchyate. Anudvegakaram vakyam. Speak words that do not agitate people's minds. Also, speak truthfully. Satyam priyahitam chayat. Speak truthfully, beneficially, pleasingly. All this is austerity of speech. So for us, before opening our mouth, austerity of speech means we open our mind. Open our mind means we don't let ourselves be driven by our own perception of the situations, our own emotions about the situations. We try to open our mind to see things from their perspective, to try to put ourselves in their feet, to feel what they are feeling. That doesn't necessarily mean that what they are feeling is right or what they are doing is right. It may be, and we might have a complete misunderstanding. Then we won't have to speak words that for which we have to apologize later. But even if they are not right, if we understand where they are coming from, if we open our mind first, then we will be able to better communicate with them effectively in a way that persuades them and doesn't alienate them. So if we speak, we open our mouth without opening our mind, then it helps neither the mouth nor the mind. Why? Because the mouth continues to speak in an undisciplined way, and what is done once is likely to be repeated again and again till we become more and more bound. And our mind stays closed, still operating on the same presumptions which it had earlier. And thus, we neither grow in our verbal discipline nor in our mental discipline. By opening ourselves to understanding the situation better, we can benefit both our mouth and our mind. By trying to understand things before we pass judgments, our conceptions will grow and our verbal discipline will also grow. Thank you. Hare Krishna.